How did they undo the guys or come Let's Play Scooby Doo Night of 100 Frights? With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's lift off. We made our way through this strange warehouse factory thing, and today we're just going to continue on. Because I've got like one thing I want to talk about today, and that is about a. If you're watching this video live, about 2 weeks, 1.5 weeks ago. Come on, get that bloody Scooby snack, man. There we go. What happened was is a certain game got released in certain areas like America, New Zealand. I think as examples, and the game was actually called Pokemon Go. Okay, and I guess I'm sort of opinionated on this, which I shouldn't be, but one thing that like started striking a chord with me was that. It got released in the States, and then once it got released in the States, the creators of the game suddenly realized that this game's a bit more popular than we expected it to be, and the infrastructure they had in place couldn't handle a global release. So what that meant was is that they had to delay the release in the United Kingdom, as well as Fishing Village. They had to delay the release in the UK as well as other countries. Why is it done this again? There we go. Okay, but they had to delay the release in other countries as well, such as the United Kingdom, not other countries as well. I think Canada was one of them as well. One way shall go back to the courtyard outside Mystic Manor. Okay, so what does that mean? It said one-way shortcut, but I think I'm gonna go look for these Scooby snacks that I'm missing anyway. And that is because the infrastructure they had couldn't handle it in the UK and stuff like that. But nevertheless, I guess they sort of missed a trick in that the game was still sort of available in the other countries, such as in the way of by tricking a device into thinking that it is actually in a valid country, such as tricking an iPhone in the UK to believe it was actually in the United States. Okay, but was an even scarier one, which I think I'm not entirely certain how it works for Android. But for Android, you could get the game as a straight APK file. And if you're not big on app development or anything like that, I work in app development, okay? I work as a app support. I work on an app support team, which means I'm building these apps every sort of day for Essentia. But if you don't know APKs, an APK is essentially the final deliverable of a Android app development, okay? So when we're developing Android applications, the IPK is actually what we are. I think we came over in here. The APK is actually the final file, which goes onto the App Store, and then you can download it. Is that so? Is from what I understand, if there is a way to get this APK for free, for instance, and then put it onto your device, that's actually theft and is actually illegal. Which is a big concern for me, because I work in app development, and not necessarily like on releases that like affect money, because it's all internal essentials, so it's all funny money really. But I don't know. It just because I work in app development, I'm sort of like, oh come on! Wow, this guy's rinsing me. Screw this guy. Because I work in app development, it sort of strikes a chord with me that where do I want to go? I want to go to the lighthouse. Let's have a quick look at the map. So it sort of strikes a chord with me. Okay. Let's just continue on Fishing Village for now. I want to see what's down here. Okay. So it sort of strikes a chord with me as being sort of wrong in a way. And I work closely with a infrastructure team. Okay. So I understand the difficulties faced of when our end users of our service don't adhere to the processes that we lay out. As in, you'd expect if your end user of a IPA or an APK that's going into a game, you would adhere to the processes which are aligned out, as in you would download it from the actual correct app store without having to hack around on your phone or anything like that. And the reason for that being is, like I say, with infrastructure teams, we set out processes for our end users to follow. And if they don't follow those processes, then it makes our job so much harder. I think we've been here before. It makes our jobs a lot more difficult and just tougher to manage. Especially because, like, the reason they've not released the app, like, officially in the United Kingdom, is because the infrastructure can't handle it. And I don't know, I guess that's just me being a bit opinionated about it, because like I say, I work in app development. Excuse me. You're having less. Right. There we go, still with him. So, I don't know, I get that people really, really want to play the game. So I can swing on this, but I get that people are really pumped to play Pokemon Go and have fun, play the game, and like, it's got, I agree with everyone, it's got its advantages. It brings people close together, it gets people out of the house, like, Scooby, looking for Pokemon and whatnot, but at what cost? Okay. It's like, and then it's normally these same people that complain about the infrastructure failing, like, they start complaining about, it keeps breaking, it's not working, and as I've said, it's because the infrastructure's not in place to support you yet. So, I guess what my whole point of this is, like, especially with stuff like this where it actually involves infrastructure, it involves servers being used in the back end, I guess I should just be saying, wait your turn on that, okay? Like, I understand it's frustrating where one country gets something after you, well before you, but we need to wait our, you need to wait your turn on that, because they're not blocking you out of spite, they're not withholding the release out of spite of anyone. Like, as producer of applications, they want you to enjoy the application as much as anyone else in the world. But if you're breaching the respective process to actually get the application, then you're making their jobs harder. And whilst I know there's rumours going around where they're talking about actually banning people that have downloaded the application, as far as that goes, I'm of a standpoint with Dark of Train on where he says they shouldn't get banned, really, because, like, it does affect the service. Like, it makes people, come on, Scooby, just get on the bloody box. It makes people not want to play the game, because, like, there's just a fear that they're going to be, they're just going to get banned. But I do believe, though, that the creators of the application have a right to call people out using this application against the correct process. Am I supposed to get that? Not to over other Scooby snacks will I give up. But yeah, that's just my thoughts on the whole Pokemon Go being downloaded in the UK. Like, I'm all for people enjoying an application. I just think we should enjoy it in the right way, you know. That's just my thoughts on that. How do I get that? I assume it's tricking me to do that, but I've got to use the pelican. Let's go and try doing that. Out the way. Okay, but that's just my thoughts. Like, I've seen my friends playing it and enjoying it, so that's for them to decide on how they enjoy their time. Okay, so is this just gonna drop me off? That's for them to enjoy, for them to decide how they want to enjoy their time. So, who am I to judge anyway? It's just one of those things. I assume I've got to fall off from the top of this pelican. Okay, so I'll just stick on him and go all the way around again. Like I said, I work in app development, and our job is made more difficult by people that don't follow the processes. But then again, It's not for me to judge how people enjoy the time and stuff like that, so... Oh! Skill, man! Skill! Get off way back. Okay, I think I got all the Scooby snacks around here. Okay, let's give it one more look. God, we're getting nothing done this episode. I think I'm just trailing around looking for Scooby snacks at this point. See if I can find any monster tokens. Oh, this is going to be such a pain. I'll come back to you when I get that box. Okay, I'm of the belief that we can actually get that until we get a gadget favor on. Is there a triple jump gadget in this game? I don't know. So let's just get back onto Fear on. Hello, how are you doing? Let's just get back through Fear on the Pier. I know there's some areas on the bottom there. But again, I'm going to wait until I get all the gadgets so I'll come back. I don't even know why I came here. I just wasted all the time while... Ooh!
Scooby!
Wasted all the time while talking about my thoughts on... Pokemon Go and it. Hang on here. My thoughts on Pokemon Go and it actually not being released officially in the UK just yet. But let me know what you think, guys. I know that a lot of people are in particular of the belief that it's actually a good thing, and if you've paid for the game, and you should be allowed to play it. But I just think they've not released it for a reason, and we're. I know it's difficult to say that, like, oh, everyone else is playing it. Well, it's easy to say that everyone else has got it, but it's just one of those things where we need to respect the developers on this one, okay? They've not released it to the public for a reason, okay? In the UK, so that's just my thoughts. Like, we need to respect the developers on that one and anyone that's publishing it, because they could be getting in a world of legal repercussions. For all we know now, because everyone else is downloading it, but I don't know. Like I say, it's not for me to say all that sort of stuff. Okay. Yes, we get it. But where's the rest of the fishing village bit? Excuse me. Yeah, maybe there isn't the rest of the fishing village. Oh, maybe it's that head stomp button. Okay, so just continue on to the lighthouse. No need to be dilly-dallying around, but yeah. Just one of those things. I've also, like, last night it was 2 weeks ago, granted, but last night I watched the Euro 2016 final, which was Portugal versus France, and personally, if you don't know the result by now, then I can't really help you, but in case you haven't, this is going to be spoilers, but Portugal won it okay, but I honestly wanted France to win it. I don't know why, I just felt like the way France are playing, they was a bit more aggressive. Like, they just seem to have a ball up front more than Portugal did. I'm of opinion that they probably played more to win it, but honestly, I don't know that much about football, so it's probably easy for me to say, oh, they were playing better, just because it looked like they were playing better, but... I don't know the whole stratagems and stuff like that. Like, if I had a talk about football with people that like football, then it'd be a pretty one-sided conversation, considering that I'm like, wait, do my boots not work on this slide? They don't. Considering that I'm it works on sticky surfaces, not slidey surfaces. Considering that I'm not a real football player, and I'm more Formula 1, which was also on this weekend, might be the outcome, but I'll live with it. And also, like, Nico Rosberg got a punishment after the race for breaking radio communication rules, and whilst I should probably argue against it, because, I should probably argue against it because, obviously, I much favour Rosberg to win the championship this year than Lewis Hamilton. But rules is rules and dems the breaks, so that's just my opinion. There's a door here, but I guess I'm not supposed to get in that door. What's in here? Good, it's finding ways to get, like... Oh, look, a witch. It's finding ways to extend this world, isn't it? No. But yeah, this is the furthest I've ever got. Actually, I think it's the first I've ever seen anyone actually get as well, so this is all blind for me. Like, I never really got past the point in the first few levels. I don't know much my brother get to the stage where he gets the helmet, but I never really anything beyond that. Oh! Should have seen that coming. Shut up, witch. Don't step on the switch, bitch. Excuse me. But yeah, I don't know, it just seemed like France were playing the better game, so I wanted France to win. It's been as like France is the closest neighbour, so again, that's another reason why I wanted France to win. Can I smash these? Oh, you can! But I've not got the head stomp, so... Ooh. But yeah, this is some Tomb Raider-esque shit, this, like... Out the way, bitch! Made it. God, this level is very tough, isn't it? I'd hate to see what it's like at the end of a game. I mean, it did say I'm about 50% of the way through it, but shit. It did seem about 50% of the way through the game, ish. 40-something? So there can't be that much longer to go. I mean, we're not even in episode 10 yet. But, like I said, these past three episodes have been slowing down. Stupid flying fish. But yeah, it's just I've also been thinking like I should probably get back on Toadlet's build server as well. It's been a while since I've spoken to the old Toadlet, you know, and but his channel's been plodding along nicely from what I've seen. And last time I tried to get on his server, it came across some sort of error, but I think that was just a temporary error anyway, so nothing really to be concerned about, so might jump back on there like this evening and just have a go around on his build server. See if I can build anything else, because I was halfway through a bridge but I never got it finished, so I've just got to do the detailing on it. But we'll see how that one goes. Yeah, I need to get a head stomp to get these buttons, man. Oh! Freaking flying fish. It's a Wormgate! Oh, there's a boat over there, do you see that? That looks like it. I need 500 snacks. I've been collecting snacks as I go, so I'm fine for snacks. But I guess I've not been collecting them as well as I should have been like the past few episodes. Like I say, I'm just going to come back and collect them all again anyway. So, yeah, I'm only on 40%, not 50%. God damn it, Tapers, getting ahead of yourself. Oh, there's a warp gate over there, that could be useful. Oh, and a groundskeeper. I hope it might have a gadget for us, actually. Since he's got one.
It's a warp gate!
Hello. Need my help again, do you? No, never, no, jib breaks, but if I like, I'm able to get up there. And I need the umbrella gadget for that. Okay, so yeah, look, it's funneling me in certain directions. Look at that boat. I'm guessing that's going to be a boss battle, and it's going to be Blackbeard or whatever he was. Or some sort of pirate ghost. What's the one with a pirate ghost? Had to have been, right? And it kind of makes sense. Oh, come on, Scooby, how did you not stick that landing? Okay, I definitely think there's going to be some kind of triple jump. There you go. Okay, just don't die. Hey, you stupid orange fish. So are these monsters actually real, or is it something else? Is it like Monsters Unleashed where they actually are real, like engineered by some sort of machine? I know, but like, I think Scooby-Doo 2 was Monsters Unleashed was definitely. Was it stronger than the first one? I think it was stronger than the first one anyway. Okay.
Buried treasure.
It's been a while since I've got one of these. But anyway, before I go in there, I'm out of time for this one, so next episode we'll just continue on and hopefully progress the game past 50%. That's 10% difference of what I make up though, so anyway. Thanks for watching this, guys, hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.